Also, Pan-Yoruba socio-political organization Afenifere on Thursday paid glowing tributes to the former governor of Lagos State, Latif Jakonde, saying that he exemplified selfless service. The National Policy Secretary of Afenifere, Yinka Odumaking, said this in a statement. The group said the late governor never lived in a government house or drive a government car throughout his service to the state. The statement also said Jakonde developed the Lekki area and never took a plot for himself because his life was all about service. Now, undoubtedly, his giant strides in housing development and free education policy in Lagos State are yet to be rivaled after 38 years when he left power. In this next report, Plus TV Africa correspondent Destiny Momo chronicles the life and times of the late Latif Jakonde, first executive governor of Lagos State.
Latif Kayode Jakonde was born in Ekpetedo area of Lagos Island on the 23rd of July, 1929. He studied at the Lagos Public School at Enuowa, Lagos Island, then at Bonham Memorial Methodist School, Port Harcourt, between 1934 to 1943. He studied briefly at King's College in 1943 and then enrolled at Ilesha Grammar School in 1945, where he edited a literary paper called The Quarterly Mirror. In 1949, Jakonde began a career in journalism, first with the Daily Service, and then in 1953, joining the Nigerian Tribune. In 1956, he was appointed editor-in-chief of the Tribune by the owner, Chief Obafemi Awolowo. After leaving the Tribune in 1975, Jakonde established John West Publications and began to publish the Lagos News. He served as the first president of the Newspaper Proprietors Association of Nigeria. Jakonde became governor of Lagos State in Nigeria from 1979 to 1983 and later became a minister of works under the Sani Abacha military regime between 1993 and 1998. He became a senior member of All Nigerian People's Party, ENPP, when the UNPP and APP merged. Jakonde was the first chairman of the Action Party of Nigeria, APN, when it was formed in November 2006. His fame and influence soared rapidly within the political atmosphere among captains of industries, and he was also courted by people that influenced the political scene in Nigeria, then as a suitable choice in politics. At the dawn of the Second Republic, he was encouraged to fully enter the political arena by his former employer and the late sage, Chief Obafemi Awolowo. However, due to Chief Awolowo's overbearing influence on him, it was not surprising when he joined the Unity Party of Nigeria, UPN, to contest for election as the executive governor of Lagos State in 1979. He won the election and was therefore elected to be the first executive governor of Lagos State. His administration was effective and typified by widespread openness that made his government to be described till date as an all-inclusive government that has ever existed in Lagos State. Jakonde has almost every major landmark achievement in Lagos State to his credit, with unrivaled records. He introduced housing and educational programs that targeted the poor, built new neighborhood primary and secondary schools, and provided free primary and secondary education. Also among his numerous accomplishments that stand till date is the Lagos State University, a citadel that has become a fountain of knowledge that has produced stalwarts in different fields of human endeavors. Jakonde's government constructed over 20,000 housing units that gave a number of Lagosians the opportunity to own their own houses. The schools and housing units were built cheaply, but were of great value. He also started a metro line project to facilitate mass transit within the Lagos metropolis. This project, if allowed by the military government that ousted his administration, would have made the perennial traffic gridlock that characterizes the state today non-existent. Destiny Momo for Plus TV Africa.
Hello, hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.